Is it possible to think too little about that which we wish to manifest? And also, in the same idea, is it possible to be too complicated in a manifestation that we've...
It is not possible to think too little for this reason. As you are moving through the contrast of your experience, the contrast gives birth to the desire, and the universe hears every particle of desire that exudes from you. Every time you have yippied and yahooed, you see, your preferences are noted. The universe is able to discern your preference. If something displeases you, the universe knows its opposite and knows what pleases you. Your sifting through the contrast is launching rockets of desire, and the universe knows more expressly than you would ever be able to articulate exactly what it is that you are wanting. So the contrast is causing you to ask for it endlessly. The universe knows exactly what you want. The question is, are you letting it in? So you say, well, could I think too little about it? And we say, actually, no, because as the contrast launches the desire, and then you do not offer any opposing thought, then you're letting it in, and it will manifest. The reason that we like this question so much is because so many of our physical friends really believe that they must find a desire and then hold tenaciously to it. And we say, you do not need to do that. Let the variety of your life keep balance in your life. You just concentrate more on holding yourself in the good feeling place where you're letting it in. An example of that would go like this. So you're driving in traffic and your car does not feel like it's functioning as well as you would like it to, and in that moment you give birth to a rocket of desire that goes something like, I would like a more dependable car. So off it goes. Now the rocket has been launched and the universe has received it. And then you are driving in traffic and you are sort of bogged down. There is some sort of an accident and your feeling is, I wish that my timing were better. I wish that I'd left a little earlier, or I wish I'd followed that impulse about leaving earlier that I felt earlier. And so you've launched another rocket. I want better timing when I'm in traffic. And then you are driving along and you see someone sort of obnoxiously cutting in and being rude in traffic, and you don't like it much. And a rocket of desire is born within you that goes something like, wouldn't it be nice if we were all yielding and getting along and being cooperative in traffic? And then you get to work and you're a little bit late, and you can see the discomfort on the faces of those who are keeping track of your time, and you launch a rocket of desire that goes something like, I wish I could be more punctual, or I wish they would not be so petty about the moment that I walk in the door. Then you sit at your desk and it's a cluttered jumble that you left the night before, and you think, I wish I had more time. I wish that I could do a better job of organizing my desk, or I wish I had an assistant to help me. And so in these kinds of ways, all through your day, through the contrast that you are living, you're launching all kinds of rockets of desire. Now, you may have recognized in our offering that some of this is kind of negative stuff. The desk is messy and people are not being nice in traffic, but just the same, your preference is being born within you. In other words, you are concluding, whether you are staying on the conclusion very long or not, you're launching all kinds of rockets about things that you would prefer in your physical life experience. So what the universe is hearing on your behalf is, begin working on orchestrating a better running vehicle and moving it toward this one. Work on the traffic patterns and give more inspiration to help this one feel the timing of the traffic and help this one be more organized. In other words, all kinds of things are moving into place. We cannot even begin to describe the specifics with which this universal orchestration is beginning to take place, but things beyond our ability to express in words are taking place on your behalf. The other day, Esther is driving, you've been hearing the tapes, you hear us talking about how Esther loves it when the numbers line up. So last week they're driving, and they were only driving about 2 hours, it was a very short distance from one city to the other. And Esther is driving the big monster bus, and Jerry is reading a book as they are moving along. And Esther looked at the clock, and it said 4:44, and she said, isn't that interesting? Haven't looked at the clock all day today, and the first time I look at the clock, it says 4:44. And as Jerry looked up, the clock said 4:45. And Esther said, really, it was 4:44. And Jerry said, I believe you, I know how clocks go. But at the moment that he looked up and they were having their fun over 4:45, the mile marker on the highway said 4:45. And Esther said, better still. In other words, she just loves that because she knows that we know how much she likes these numbers lining up. And so every time it happens, she knows that it is universal orchestration. And we say to you, it is nothing less. It is nothing less than extraordinary, precise, universal orchestration. When you find vibrational harmony with anything when you've launched these desires, the universe is working on assisting you in the receiving of them. In other words, they're all lining up for you. So then when you are not holding a thought of opposition, then you're letting it in. So, can I think too little about it? You really can't, because contrast prods you into conscious, constant launching of rockets. And if you are chilling out and basking and appreciating and petting your cat and living happily ever after, then you're letting it in. You don't have to think about it. But you might want to think about it, because nothing is more exhilarating than to think about what you're wanting. In other words, once you launch a rocket, there's strong energy that is moving on that rocket. And when you use your visualization to focus upon it, it's like riding the rocket. The other reason that we want to emphasize that is because you are on the leading edge of thought. And the reason that you came forth to be in the specific nitty-gritty of all of this is because the closer to the manifestation you are in terms of your consciousness, the more thrilling the energy is as it flows through you. The way you might hear that is when you really, 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 really want something and it manifests, and you've given a lot of conscious thought to it, isn't a more thrilling experience as it begins to unfold? The other reason is because everything that you've been wanting, the universe is lining up for you. And the more intricately you have become involved in offering the details of it, the more satisfying it is to you as the universe yields it to you. It gives you that stronger feeling of hands in the clay in your molding process, you see. Once the universe receives your request, there are endless answers that keep coming forward. In other words, it is not possible for your ship to come in and you not be at the pier. Because there is another and another and another and another, because the universe never stops answering your request. The universe never stops answering your request, and it is not possible for you to stop asking. The only thing that sometimes goes wrong is you forget the question. In other words, you forget that you've asked it, and so that is the advantage of getting very specific and staying specifically, vibrationally, consciously connected to your question, is that the more intimately involved you are with the question, the more you are aware as the answer begins coming, you see. And the more fun it is. One more thing we want to give to you about this. Sometimes people think, I will be very deliberate about my vibration. I will be very deliberate about my asking. I will be very deliberate about my manifestation, because that's the way I get what I want. And we say, that is the way you get what you want. But that attitude is like sort of shooting yourself in the foot, because when you say, I'll do this process so that I can have this end result, because I want to get from over here to over here, you begin including both vibrations in your vibration. You say, here I am where I don't want to be, so I'm going to do this process so that I can be over here where I do want to be, but I'm really over here where I don't want to be, so I'll do this process so I can be over here where I do want to be, but I'm over here where I don't want to be, so I'll do this process so I can get over here where I do want to be, but I'm really over here where I don't want to be, so I'll do this process so I can... And that vibration is like having one foot in both worlds, the world where it isn't happening, the world where you're wanting it to happen, and guess what happens in that situation? You don't get pregnant.